Hello, Taurus. This is your Mercury in retrograde reading. It's going to happen later in March, about March 22nd. You'll probably feel it before that. And it goes into April, and you'll probably feel it a while in April. You also have Uranus coming into your sign soon, I think around May. And you may feel that energy coming in. It's kind of chaotic energy. And it could either bring in a little, like I said, chaos or sudden windfalls. So I'm trying to figure out, you know, what's going on with Taurus. And then we got these energies, like I said, Mercury in retrograde. That's when things can go a little ass backwards or a little, you know, off kilter with communications, travel arrangements, contracts, relationships, you name it. But it's a temporary energy, but it's, you'll still feel it, possibly. A lot of people do. Not all people, but a lot of people do, and they like these readings. And it's the energies coming towards you, and you can control these energies. So, Mercury in retrograde, Taurus, what's going on? What's coming towards them? What's coming towards Taurus or Mercury in retrograde, March 2018, April 2018? Mercury in retrograde, Taurus, energies coming towards you. I do pre-shuffle these, as you know. I have to repeat that sometimes. Like I said, may not resonate with all Taurus, but I know Uranus is going to somewhat. So if you're feeling it already, try leaving it in the comments. Completion has not occurred. You're not done with something. And it may, you know, we're going to find out more. There's no way I could tell you more about that. High Priestess. Possibly waiting on an offer, maybe to come in, and maybe an obstacle waiting for an offer to come in. You're in the upright, Taurus. You're in the upright. You're balanced during this time. That's a good thing. A lot of people aren't during this time. Let me find out what's going on. Completion has not occurred. It's going to be, you know, it's still going on. Something's ongoing. Now you got the High Priestess in the past that's coming in towards Mercury in retrograde. And this is could be someone of a Pisces type energy. Someone who's secretive. They don't let you know everything they're doing. They got good intuition. They're a bit of a mystery. Now that's coming towards you. Why is the High Priestess? Oops. No. Because I don't know how that fell. I'm going to put it right there at the head. That's the Emperor. Could be an Aries type energy. A fire type energy. So you got that coming towards you also. The High Priestess, why are you there? That's what we want to know. The High Priestess, why are you there? Huh. This High Priestess that's coming towards you usually doesn't come out too much, doesn't talk about themselves at all. They keep everything to themselves. They're always thinking. And they may, for some reason, want to come towards you during this time. I gotta move these over. Oh, this camera. I want you to see these. Emperor fell out. So you got someone in hermit mode previously that's kind of secret, a mystery, that may be coming towards you. They may have something important to say because you got the Emperor. Maybe a decision has to be made. Maybe they have something to say to you. Can you see that? I'm trying to keep the glare off the cards. So the lights aren't exactly bright on here. The Ace of Discs is an obstacle, but you're thinking it's an obstacle, but it's coming towards you. Maybe you're wanting an offer to come in. You're waiting for an offer to come in of some sort. Could be financially, you know, in tune with something you're wanting. So, you're waiting for something to come in. You're waiting for a fresh start of something. Ace of Discs. Why are you the obstacle? Why are you there? Yeah, it's about money. You're waiting for some money to come in. You're waiting for some cash. You're waiting for maybe a job. It could be your taxes. You know, it's tax time this year. So you're waiting for something to come in as an obstacle. It could be that someone's wanting money from you. So could be taxes. But it's an obstacle. It could be that you're waiting on it and wanting it. Because you got the current environment at that time. What's going on at that time. the Sun card reverse. So it's not a terrible card reverse. It just means it's not 100% the way you want it, or may come, or something else may occur that's a good thing, but you may not see it as a good thing. Let me find out. Why Sun card? Why are you there? And that is a major arcana, by the way. So it's there. And so is the High Priestess and the Emperor. So Sun card, why are you reversed? Why are you there? That's a Five of Swords. And the Five of Swords, it's a Five of Swords. Eternal light. The Five of Swords there is someone may not want to put up a fight on something. It could be something you're wanting. It's not necessary. It doesn't have to be a physical battle, even though this sometimes is attached to a physical battle. It's like you're trying to get one up. You're trying to sit there and succeed to win. And you may not feel like you're winning. That's a feeling. This is a feeling I'm thinking you're getting. It's coming towards you also. Someone may not feel like you're winning towards you. So it could be maybe someone also, this is another way of putting it, someone could be making you an offer with cash, but they may not feel like you're going to accept it. Maybe it's this hermit type guy that would, or woman that never came out before, and they're making a judgment call with the Emperor. Now you got the Queen of Swords there, and that's also an overall environment coming in. That's the Queen of Swords, and that's an air sign. It could be Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. And attached to her is the Queen of Wands. So you got two queens coming in. So you could have two different people you're dealing with during this time, or it could be someone with both these energies, and they both rule. They both know what they want. They know both know what they're doing. Yeah, you got something coming in. It could be someone from the past too, or someone you knew from the past wanting to make a decision with you. I'm seeing a lot of decision making here. The decision is on the table. Now with this, like I said, this could be an air sign. This could be fire, and then, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, and someone is requiring you to make a decision, or they may make a decision. And it could be, like I said, it could be over this money situation. I don't know, you got some people here running around, because at the end you got the Queen of Disc in the upright. And the Queen of Disc, when she's in the upright, she's got everything going for her. She's stable, she's independent, she's got good character, she knows what she wants. So why are you there? Why are you at the end? Why are you there, Queen of Disc? Why are you at the end upright? Oh yeah, I got the Emperor. So something's coming in. An offer. Someone may be a little afraid you may say no. This person is kind of hermit anyway, so they may, be a little bit shy about coming towards you, but they need to make that decision. And it could involve two different people, or maybe this is two different people, coming in. But a decision is going to be made, and you're in the upright, and you're getting a blessing out of it. So you may get that windfall eventually, but that's in May. But you're going to start feeling it. You're going to start feeling things start really revving up. So that is your energy for Mercury in retrograde. If this resonates, put it in the comments. And like I said, it may not resonate with all of you. It may just a couple of you, not a couple of you, but a few of you. And it may be a little bit different for everybody. But here's, you got a lover situation reverse. So it could very well be from someone in the past that did not work out. Or maybe someone you're wanting to work out. Maybe there was a partnership of some sort that didn't work out, and now they may come to you with a new offer. That is also a possibility. But whatever it is, you're in the upright. And this is your energy. I feel it's your energy with the Empress giving you her blessings. Okay? That is your reading, and I'm glad you got a good one. Bye.